my being invited as a professor, I thought, gave me the right to apply for a non-quota visa. They accepted my request as a request, and in a few weeks wrote back, "Sorry, you cannot be admitted." I was very happy in England, and I was just as happy not to come. But Mici, who had visited in the United States, was absolutely adamant, "We have to go." And both of us, and particularly she, had a Hungarian friend by the name of Thomas Balogh. He was in the same high school as I, and for whatever reason, not clear to me, we used to call him, in his student days, Lord Balogh. That is what he became eventually. He went to England, was an excellent economist, and was knighted and made a lord. At that time, he wasn't yet. But Mici complained to him, and he said, "I'll go and state it out." And he did go to the American embassy and found out why I wouldn't be admitted. I asked for a non-quota visa and got a professorship, but a non-quota visa cannot be granted for an occupation that you did not exercise for the last year before you applied for the visa. I was a professor at the time I applied. But a few months earlier, I was a Rockefeller Fellow rather than a professor. So I could not get the non-quota visa. However, they also told Balogh, which they did not tell me, that the Hungarian quota was not filled, and all I had to do was to apply for a quota visa, then I could be admitted. So that is how, for the second time, I got into a little trouble with American administration, which, however, with appropriate effort and good luck, was surmounted. I accepted Gamow's invitation.